ViaGuard Acumetrics, science and technology at its best.
Hi, my name is Harvey Tenenbaum, Director of Laboratory Operations for ViaGuard Acumetrics, a leading DNA firm. And today we're going to talk about one particular aspect of DNA and genetic analysis, and that is the tendency of certain genes to influence the onset of Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease, in the last number of years, has been recognized as a scourge of old age, a dreaded disease, fatal, but in addition to that, a destroyer of a person's quality of life and mental faculty and relationship with society. It is a very serious, devastating disease. It's very widespread. It has affected many millions of people in North America. Many millions more will be affected. And there's nothing that can be done to stop Alzheimer's. But much can be done to mitigate its effect and defer any devastation that it infects. Now, what is Alzheimer's disease? Alzheimer's disease, in its simplest form, is a disease affecting certain critical areas of the brain. We know the physical cause of Alzheimer's disease. It's been well studied. Alzheimer's disease is caused by the ongoing deposition of a substance known as beta amyloid plaques, which deposit in certain areas of the brain. What the plaques do is they inhibit and block the transmission of neural signals from one nerve to the next. They impair and impede brain function. As brain function is impeded, your brain starts to shrink and deteriorate in those areas. The cognitive areas are the ones most affected. Memory, recognition, all the things we tend to take for granted. Now, a great deal of research and study has gone into Alzheimer's disease. It is a very complex disease. There are environmental factors, and there are important genetic factors. Let's talk for a second about the genetic factors. Our laboratory, following the lead of institutions across the world that have done extensive research, has identified a gene called the APOE gene as being an important causative factor in Alzheimer's. In other words, you may be 10 years old, but if you have a particular variant of that gene, the number 4 variant in particular, you have a very high, much above average proclivity for contracting Alzheimer's disease as you progress in age. Now, it's not a certainty, but it's a high tendency for that to develop. That itself is very alarming. It's been estimated that up to 75% of people with Alzheimer's, in fact, have this mutant of the APOE gene. When we do a test and we identify that particular mutant, it's difficult to pass that information on to the affected individual, but critically important because much can be done to mitigate the onset and duration and impact of Alzheimer's. There are lifestyle changes, there are dietary changes, mental exercises, physical conditioning, a whole range of substances. Things as simple as an ingestion of a product called resveratrol, which is abundantly found in things like Concord grapes, have been found to have a great influence in mitigating and deferring the onset of Alzheimer's. There are many dietary steps, nothing exotic, straightforward and simple. Many exercises and lifestyle changes, nothing exotic, nothing that the average person can undertake and successfully implement, and they may be buying for themselves 20 more years avoiding dementia and Alzheimer's. It's critically important. So that's why the Alzheimer's test is important, because if it serves to buy some people an expanded length of time for the quality of life they want, it is more than justified. The test is simple. It consists of a saliva sample containing some buccal cells coming to our lab, from which we will isolate the APOE gene and determine the variant and send a report with the situation as we find it. Now, if you want to do this test, kits are sent out at no cost. It's a simple sample collection kit, simple piece of membrane paper for the sample to go on for return to our lab. It comes to us, payment, it's $395, is made when the samples return for analysis. So feel free to phone us and discuss your situation, but we would encourage those people, particularly ones who have a family history of Alzheimer's being prevalent or any other reason for concern, to consider the advantages of this dramatic increase in medical technology that's now available to help the public improve the quality of their life.